Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. So inshallah, today's video we're talking about the Imam Mahdi army, the Khorasan army, or the TALIBAN army. Are they the army? Is this the one that will have the Mahdi in them? So inshallah, we'll be talking about them today in this video. But before I do that, I want to mention a few things. First of all, number one is we know that this Khorasan army, as I said, TALIBAN, they have seized a Ghazni governor and he was arrested. He tried to flee, but he was arrested. This is a big thing, you know, a governor. So this army, you know, this Khorasan army is becoming ever more ferocious, looks like. They are not going to relent. It is going to be something very, very dangerous and something that they will not give up. And they are seeing victories one after another. So things are getting pretty intense for them. The Khorasan army armed group has taken control of Ghazni. So not only that they have captured the governor, but they have taken control the capital of Ghazni province. So you can imagine the capital, not just the city, but this is the capital, about 130 kilometer or 80 miles southwest of capital Kabul. In another report, US intelligence, they said that Taliban will capture Kabul in the next 3 months. After 90 days, we will see the Khorasan army is in complete control. They have complete power in the country. It becomes the 10th provincial capital to fall within days. Ghazni is the 10th provincial capital. A government source tells Al Jazeera that the Afghan government has offered the Taliban a share in power so long as the rising violence in the country comes to a halt. Right now, what it means is that the Afghan government, they are begging. Wallahi, literally they're begging to this Khorasan army, saying that please stop whatever you're doing. Stop, we want you to stop doing all of these things. We will share our power, you know. Let's get along, let's share our power, let's be happy, let's have it all. Like, let's, you know, during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was some liars, the prophet, the Kadhab. They came to Rasulullah that he said that you rule half, I rule half. It doesn't work that way. This is absolutely ridiculous. You only have one ruling party. You have only ruling one ruling power. You cannot share power and say, oh, the country will run fine. If that happens, if there is like two ruling party, then it means that the country is divided. And that is not going to happen. And that's not what Taliban wants. Quote unquote, this is what the reporter said from Al Jazeera. The Khorasan army have just tweeted that they have taken Kandahar city. Wallahi, they are running over many, many provinces, and they are running over many, many cities, important cities. The Kandahar is the birthplace, I believe, for the Khorasan army. We don't understand that to be entirely true. This is what the reporter said, but we do understand that there is intense fighting happening in Kandahar city night, she said. Okay, so at least she confirmed there is something going on. Earlier today, we understand, again, this reporter is saying, we understand that the Taliban had been pushing, but it's only just now that we have started to hear a little bit of information about the Taliban, the Khorasan, being in the heart of the city. Dear brothers and sisters, I want to play a video. You can see for yourself what is the situation right now.
Residents have confirmed to us that they are inside the police headquarters, inside the governor's compound, inside intelligence officers, the election commission, multiple government buildings. They've even taken the prison and released prisoners. The Ministry of Defense says that they are going to launch a clearing operation to take the city back, but for all intents and purposes, the city of Kunduz has fallen to the Taliban. It is a very significant city. In 2015 and 2016, it briefly fell to the Taliban. It's the only city that fell to the Taliban in the last 20 years. And the reason that it got back into government hands is because US Special Forces were deployed on the ground.
Wow.
But now, of course, US Special Forces are not on the ground, and the Afghan government is having to try do it alone, sometimes with the help of US airstrikes, but mostly through their own air force and their own troops. Now, the Taliban is also claiming that they have taken the province of Saripol. They put out a statement in it. They said that they seized a huge amount of weapons from both Kunduz and Saripol, and that they are asking soldiers to surrender or be killed. Also in the south, the province of...
Okay, so what we can see and understand from this, your message is very, very clear, which is that without US support, this government, Afghan government, they are really nothing. They're nothing. The city was under the Afghan government for 20 years, and that was simply because of US presence there. Okay, if US is not there, that means we will not have the city under our control. So Afghan government is really, really weak. They're doing nothing. They can do nothing. Like, can you imagine, they have all the weapons and they have all the power and money and everything you can imagine. And Taliban, on the other hand, has nothing. Yet they cannot protect these cities. They cannot defend these cities. Wallahi, this is a open and very clear defeat on the Afghan government forces part. I want to mention to you something very, very important, as I said in the beginning, and that would be the Khorasan army, the Imam Mahdi army that I said. We have seen what the Khorasan army is capable of doing. My position in this, it will remain the same, which is that I do not believe that these Taliban are the Mahdi army. I do not believe, because they practice so many things that are not Islamic, they're brutal. Okay, I do not support them in that sense, and I do not believe, but I do believe that this group, okay, this Khorasan army group will form part of the Mahdi army. Okay, they are going to form. So I'm not here to kind of like, you know, flacking anyone. It is just my opinion. I could be wrong, but I would not at this point say they are the Khorasan army or the Mahdi army. The hadith that I want to share with you, it is very, very clear, as we, dear sisters, we all know that there will be three sons of Khalifa fighting for a treasure. Okay, yaqtatilu 'inda kanzikum salasa kulluhum ibnu Khalifa. Rasulullah said that there will be fighting for treasure three, and all of them, kulluhum ibnu Khalifa, all of them are the son of Khalifa. La yasirru minhum ahada. None of them will be able to get anything from it. Okay, none of them will be able to obtain it. Then he said, now this is the part that I want you to understand. Rasulullah, after he said that there will be this, you know, turmoil taking place, he said, "Takhruju min Khurasan." There will come from Khurasan what? Ra'yatu, a black banner. Wallahi, this is the part of the hadith, very, very important. Ra'yatu sudun, a black banner will come from Khurasan, place called Khurasan. Then he said, "La yarudduhu," nothing will be able to return them. Nothing will be able to turn them away. Okay, once the black banner is being raised, nothing will turn them away. Hatta, until they will reach where? You get it, Al-Quds, Jerusalem. Okay, dear my sisters, this is the description of the army, even though it is a Do'if hadith, but we know from other narration that yes, the Mahdi army will actually appear from a place called Khorasan, and this army, they are so dangerous. Rasulullah said that they will attack you in an unprecedented manner. Okay, this army is not a normal ordinary army. They will attack you in an unprecedented manner. And if you see them, Rasulullah said after this hadith, the same hadith, he said, if you see this army, go and give them baya, even if you have to crawl over snow. Point here is that, dear sisters, from the hadith, what we can understand is that perhaps this group, okay, this Khorasan army, the Taliban, they are becoming so big, and they're coming on the news, and they are growing, they're gaining so many lands, and they're getting a lot of power in the country, is a clear indication that there will be groups in that region, Khorasan. As we know, Afghanistan is part of Khorasan, who would have this help from Allah Azza wa Jal to overcome all the barriers and difficulties until they will have the black banner raised and the Mahdi will be in that army. The Prophet said, go and give them baya, because in that army is the Mahdi. Dear sisters, one thing we know for sure, whether Taliban is the army, the Mahdi army or not, directly, indirectly, or part of it, we know one thing for sure, that the characteristic of these people is such, okay, that they are without any weapon, without any modern weapon, without any sophistication of the modern technology, they're able to defeat their enemy. And they can overrun cities, they can capture land, they can establish their power, seems like without really much effort. And it is happening so fast, it is catching the Western powers off guard. They did not expect this to happen, but it is happening right now. Allahu alam what the future will hold, but this is something very, very interesting for all of us to understand. especially if you are interested in learning end of time Islamic eschatology and whatnot, coming of the Dajjal and the Mahdi. If you're new to this channel, dear my sisters, consider subscribing, like this video, share this video, and inshallah I'll see you soon again. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.